sensory. You get to hear tonality. You get to see my smile. You get to hear my voice, right? Versus email. You ever misread an email? And more importantly, you ever had somebody else misread yours? Like, I didn't say that. Yes, you did. No, I didn't. I didn't say that. There's no tonality. They can't judge. They can't see that. So it's very, very important that as you're creating your business strategy, that you learn how to integrate video, that you get comfortable in front of a camera. I had a lady, she raised her hand at one of my presentations probably a year ago, and she said, I don't like video. My hair looks funny and I look fat. I kind of looked over and there was a guy that was presenting with me, Casey, you remember? And he looked over and he goes, honey, it looks just like you. It's a video. I'm sorry. It's video, right? It is you. If you're in person, that's who they see, right? If we're talking on the phone, that's who you hear. You hear me. I don't think I sound like this when I listen to these things back. Every time I'm like, that ain't me. It's the acoustics. The room is weird. All right, education. It is your job to provide education because people have questions. If you're not educating, informing, teaching, lecturing, what's going to happen? Someone else is going to do that. As consumers, you want to be an educated consumer, yes? Are you more interested in having someone sell to you or educate you? Always educate. Bless you. Always educate. So you have to figure out, how do you take an educational component about your business, and how do you disseminate that content, that information? What mediums? So some of this crosses over, because you're going to create educational content, distribute it through social media, distribute it through blogs, distribute it through search engines. That's a great part about how all this works. You can take 1 hour of time. My time right now, she's recording it here. I'm going to use this content how many times, do you think? Let's put things in perspective. The number one reason why people say that they're not going to do this, what do you think the biggest excuse is? I don't have enough what? Okay, so let's get this. What if I came here and I spoke for an hour? You can text, just Facebook me, I don't care if you text. She looks like she got caught. All right, so what if I came here and I spent my hour talking to you and I didn't record any of it? What did I just lose? Did I lose it? I can make better use of it. It's not that you don't have enough time, it's that you're misusing your time. You're not using it effectively. You're not capitalizing on it. You're not leveraging it. Me leveraging this out, oh, it was me too. I have to catch myself. Have you heard me say I don't have enough time? Like in our office is kind of a weird place to be because we have all these slogans and statements and you get caught all the time. We have this whole, I give permission to get on your tail about anything you do wrong or say wrong or eat wrong. So it's an odd place to work, because if any of us are out of line, we're kind of like, did you say I don't have enough time? Did you just say that? I heard you say that. You're not supposed to say that. So it's just very frustrating. But if you can get accountability partners in your life, partners, spouses, individuals, best friends, if you can get those people in your life that get on the same page with you and they hold you accountable and they keep pushing you to make better decisions, this will be easier. I can't do this alone. If I'm by myself, I'm going to be on the couch. But I know I have to meet him at 5:45 in the morning, and I got to make sure she gets there because she says I bring her to the gym unwillingly.
I'm not a morning person.
With force, right? But it takes all of us. It takes having to report back to him at lunch. He's like, how's the gym? I would hate to say I didn't go. I'd be like, I don't know. Okay. All right, so very important. All right, education critical. Next. Blog. Blogs outperform websites 100 to 1. Blogs. It says better listings on Google. Blog is not a nasty four-letter word. All it is a dynamic database that allows you to add content to the internet, content over content over content over content, like a diary, like a journal. Ladies, when we were young and we used to write our diaries, that's all a blog is. But it doesn't have to be a diary. It's a system that allows you to answer people's questions. And we'll talk more about that in a minute. Next. So you have some other slots in here. There may be some other things that in your business are great ways for you to get business. Maybe you have a directory listing that you're on. Maybe you have an ad that's worked for you. I don't know. But add those things in there as well. Do you feel like, does anyone feel like you track all of these perfectly? You know where every single piece of business comes from like this? You will now, okay? Because you have to. All right, next. Left-hand side, number two, listen. Left-hand side, number two, listen. This is one of the most important skills, one of the most important pieces of your business, the ability to listen. What do consumers want? What are their questions? Not what are yours. What do you think they want to hear? That's not it. That's old school marketing messages. What do they really want? What questions do they really have? Once you find those out, you're going to come up with a series of what we call keywords. Have you heard that? A little bit for internet stuff? My fellow geek over here. All right, keywords. On the left-hand side, don't do it right now. However, this is your task. Your task is to come up with the top 5 or 10 things you think people are asking or looking for. And you're going to get them in that list. You're going to create a list. We'll have a whole nother session on this. We'll show you how to research it, vet it, see if you're accurate or not. We'll teach you how to create those keyword lists, okay? On the right-hand side. Next one is answer. If people are having those questions, it's your job to answer. This is going to sound really, does it sound too simple, too basic? No? Kind of. It is simple. People overcomplicate this like crazy. They're getting all these acronyms. I told you you're going to go home with a bunch of acronyms. Look, listen and answer. Okay? Sorry. All right, listen. I don't have any fancy acronyms for you today. I have a different class that has those, though. All right, so listen and answer. In a customer service environment, in a sales organization, if you have people talking to customers, every time you hear the same question twice, you just wasted your time. So think about this way. It's not that I don't have time to blog, because if somebody asks a question in a sales appointment and you hear that same question 2 or 3 times, how many times are you going to have to answer that? Forever. Right? I'm going to have to answer the same question over and over and over again. Or I'm going to create a video that has that question and the answer pre-prepared. So the next time I get the question, what do? Shoot them the link. When I create that video, I'm going to put it on YouTube and I'm going to optimize it. That's a whole other training class, but I'm going to optimize that. So the next time somebody goes to YouTube or goes to Google and they type in that question, I have new people that find the same question that I've been asking and answering one-on-one. We can go to a conference room and I can sit in here with a prospect or a potential customer and I can answer your question over and over and over again. And I can do that 100 times a year. But if I don't digitize those questions and those answers and put them somewhere where other people can find them, how are you spending your time? That's killer. Killer. I actually, and trust me, all of these things are lessons from my own business. I used to have, I'm really, really good at generating leads. And we give away a free consultation. I used to sit inside a conference room from 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. doing free consultations. Hour after hour after hour after hour. Until I learned that most of the time I was spending educating them on how their website was performing. I was showing them how to evaluate it, what tools to use to evaluate it. What if I took that same evaluation and I put it into a video and I threw it up on the internet? You know what happens? 5 days after I posted it, I have 100 views and 13 calls and new customers. Smarter use of my time, and they're still doing the same thing. But I'm getting 100 times the results for it. This is the cool part. That 1 hour that I spent doing that consultation before used to only last an hour. Guess what happens to that video after 5 years on the internet? Doesn't have 100 views on it. How many does it have now? Thousands. How much money has it made me? Digitize your stuff. Leverage technology in order to make more of you. In order to replicate you. Does that make sense? Okay, cool. I like that. So, answer. Next, communication. This entire workshop, that's all this is about, is communication. It's not really about anything else. And we're going to communicate 4 different ways. You have to have a balance between all 4. First one, live, face-to-face. Second one, video. Third, text. Fourth, audio. You're going to do exactly what you do right now. The only difference is you have to create a balance between how you communicate and where you communicate. Use all 4. You cannot stand on a one-legged chair. It's very hard. But if you put all 4 together, It's going to be much stronger. Much, much stronger, okay? By the way, when I'm saying things like video and audio, I'm not talking about a $10,000 professional video. I'm talking about pieces of technology that might cost you 50 bucks a month and a little bit of time. You're never going to see me come and talk about these huge, really expensive, mass amounts of money and so forth, pieces of technology. It's not necessary. The core infrastructure for you to be in a good position for a startup company all the way through a mid-sized company, you're not talking about tens of thousands of dollars. Okay, it's not like that anymore. All right, next. So everything is surrounded by what we call a connection and conversation hub. Other people refer to it as a website. Websites are dead. They died. They don't exist anymore. The traditional website, home, about us, our services, contact us, maybe an FAQ, bye-bye now. There's a trillion web pages on the internet and growing. Trillions. A website that is a static brochure slapped on the internet, do you think Google thinks they're exactly who they should present to a consumer that's looking for someone that's current and relevant and informative and educational and trusted by others? Never. Websites are very quickly being pushed off the planet because Google wants the same thing we do. Google is smart. They're very smart. I want something that is relevant, educational, current, and trusted by others. Website's not going to do that. However, a blog will. So a website with an integrated blog is the only way to do business today. Separating them means you're going to drive a whole bunch of traffic to a blog. Congratulations, you have a lot of Reader's Digest people, but you won't convert any business. Websites are still critical in order to convert, and to convert those into new consumers, potential prospects, leads, opportunities, and customers. Cash, more importantly.
Important?
Okay. All right, so think about those two words. Connection. I need to use this piece of technology to connect with potential customers. And conversion. I need them to do something. So if I'm listening, I'm going to know what they're looking for. If I'm answering, they're going to be interested in coming into that hub and converting. And that's how all this starts piecing together. All right.